The best in the whole wide world. I have the best pumpkin carver in the whole wide world with me right here. And now I'm hanging out with Kelly Geiger from the Tri-C Culinary Arts Institute. Good morning, Kelly.
Good morning.
All right, so I got to tell you, you whipped this pumpkin up in like no time at all. Wow, that's pretty awesome. Now, you were telling me one of the big trends now is 3D pumpkin carving.
Yes.
We have a couple of images that we're going to show people on air right now of some 3D pumpkin carving. So it's more of an art form when we do 3D, is that right? Because you have a lot of texture in this pumpkin carving that you did today.
Yes, it's a lot harder, especially getting the shadows and the dimensions correct.
Because that's not an easy canvas, is it?
It's pumpkin.
Not. my engineer Bob was like, well, if she pushes too hard, she might poke a hole inside of it. So you kind of have
to. And it happens all the time.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So why don't you show people what you were working on at the very end here? Well, here's some 3D stuff right here. So we're talking about you can cut. Not only does it have texture and dimension, people actually use color to bring that out. Is that right?
Yes. And those look really nice. Those are very good. Mm-hmm. We put a lot of time into those. And then the coloring, you can either use dye, you can use paint, acrylic, watercolor sometimes, or food coloring.
Wow, it's like a little piece of pumpkin art, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so on yours here, now give people the summary of what you were doing. We see a lot of little pumpkin shavings right here.
I was going for the weathered face, and this is only the very, very beginning stages still. Mm-hmm. The pros will take this base, even though it looks like it's been, you know, worked on for quite a while. They'll keep going and shaving and shaping. So I was going for like an old man, scary old man kind of guy. And I gave him a few moles here and there just to make him look Halloweenish. And I'll keep working on the nose.
The closer we get, the more you see. That's pretty amazing. Now, you just did a class recently. Tell us about the class where you had parents and their kids coming in doing some pumpkin carving.
Yeah, we invited the little ones, and it was a great time because we showed them a few things. We showed them how to use the non-sharp clay carving tools to start skinning the pumpkin, and then we did stencils for the smaller ones. Ah. And you could see the creative minds just racing. It was awesome.
And the cool part about this is you don't have to go inside and get messy with it, so
no.
That's pretty awesome.
You can if you want.
If you want, that's right. And then one of the secrets you told us, bleach, once you scrape the skin off, you put some bleach on there, and why was that, Kelly?
Mm-hmm. That kills the germs that cause the decay. It kills enough of them so that the pumpkin lasts longer. And then we use water spray jets to get the pumpkin out of the crevices. Mm-hmm.
Kelly Geiger, ladies and gentlemen, pumpkin carver extraordinaire from Tri-C Culinary Institute. Thank you so much, Kelly,
Thank
for coming
you.
Out. You did a great job. That
Thank
was like
you.
Less than an hour and a half. I'm pretty impressed, man.
Thank you.
Wow. That's why she's the king. All right, we're going to go back to you guys over there.
Thank you. Looks nothing like the ones we carve at home.
No.
Oh my.